Yes, three-phase induction motor is called as a three-phase transformer. The things has been discussed in previous few lectures. So three-phase induction motor has two winding. One is the stator winding and second is the rotor winding. Stator winding treated as a primary winding and rotor winding treated as a secondary winding. The difference is that in case of transformer, the primary winding and secondary winding both are placed over the common core, whereas in case of three-phase induction motor, the winding is separated by a small air gap and the power is going to transfer by the induction process through or via air gap. The secondary winding short-circuited itself and it does not have a secondary voltage similar to the transformer. Whatever the secondary voltage is there in case of rotor winding, it is going to circulate in the, it is drive the current in the rotor circuit. So when the three-phase induction motor is generalized a three-phase transformer, definitely the vector diagram of three-phase induction motor is similar to the transformer. So in transformer, we will take the reference quantity as a flux. So here we have taken the reference quantity as a flux and under no load condition, it will draw a no load current I0. This no load current I0 has two components. One is the magnetizing component I mu and second component is IW. The I mu or this magnetizing component is responsible to produce the required magnetic flux in the air gap, whereas IW is going to supply the core losses in the stator winding. The no load current of three-phase induction motor is higher, say 8 to 12% as compared to the transformer where the no load current is hardly 5 to 6%. In case of three-phase induction motor, it has windage and frictional losses. Therefore, an air gap is there. Because of these two reasons, the no load current is higher as compared to the transformer. Now, three-phase induction motor secondary current, that is the rotor current, is I2. Therefore, the resistance drop, it is I2 R2 in phase with the current. And the current I2 is get reflected in the stator winding is represented I2 dash. The addition of I2 dash and I0 is the total current drawn by the stator winding is I1. Okay. Now, this I1, current I1 in the stator winding, there is a resistance in the stator winding. There is definitely a resistive drop in phase with the current. It is I1 R1. EMF induced in the stator winding, it is minus E1. It is referred to the primary side. And in quadrature, there is a reactance drop. It is I1 X1 and total voltage is V1 or voltage supplied to the stator winding is V1. Now, the secondary voltage is going to circulate the current in the rotor conductors. So here, this is the reactive drop, which is in quadrature or in 90 degree with the current. It is I2 S X2 under running condition. And this is the ER, which is equal to S into E2. So this is the some description of vector diagram as a generalized three-phase transformer. So under such condition, we can draw an equivalent circuit of stator winding where it having resistance, it having reactance and exciting component or shunt component of equivalent circuit. So this resistance is R1, reactance X1, current in the this one is I1, current is I1. Here the current is I0, no load current I0. It has two components. One component is I mu and second component is IW. So this is the equivalent circuit. Now, similar to transformer, we can find the resistance of the shunt component. It is R0 is equal to V1 divided by IW, it is in ohm, and X0 is equal to V1 divided by I mu. So this is the value of X0 and this is the R0. The R0 represent the core loss in the stator wind, in the stator part, whereas X0 is represent the exciting component in the machine. Now here it is the supply voltage is V1. So we can write as a Kirchhoff voltage law for this one, for this component of the current, it is V1 is equal to, from this vector one, from this vector, we can write V1 is equal to E1 plus I1 R1 plus J I1 X1. Similarly, the rotor circuit, the rotor, similarly, the rotor circuit can be represented as, one more thing, it is a no load current. I0 is equal to IW plus square plus I mu square under root. So this is the stator part calculation. Whereas the rotor, rotor circuit, this is the stator circuit, now rotor circuit, Rotor circuit consists of resistance and reactance. Whereas, resistance and reactance is S into X2. So, which is a variable, as the load increases, there is a change in slip. So, this is the rotor circuit R2. This is ER across the rotor circuit, and this represents S into X2. Now, this rotor circuit can be represented as, this is the resistance, and instead of resistance, we will write, we will draw the inductance as a constant one, and resistance is variable. Resistance is variable in such a way that it is X2 ER and it is R2 divided by S, or it can be written as, it can be drawn, this equivalent circuit, rotor circuit, can be drawn as resistance as it is, which represent the copper losses in the rotor circuit, reactance of the rotor circuit. Now it will represent the load resistance, RL, load resistance, RL. So it is ER, it is R2, X2, and RL is equal to R2 into bracket, 1 minus 1 upon S minus S, 1 upon S minus 1. Okay. So the circuit will remain as it. See here, we can say that this is the resistance is R2. This resistance we are getting added R2 divided by S minus R2. So this get cancelled, this get cancelled, and remaining is R2 upon S. This is the R2 upon S. So this these are the equivalent circuit. So total equivalent circuit of a three-phase induction motor become the stator part, resistance, reactance, and this is the exciting component. Exciting component, whereas this is the resistance of rotor circuit, reactance of rotor circuit, and load resistance. So here it is the current I2 dash, whereas it is R2, X2, R2 into bracket 1 minus 1 upon s minus 1. It is R1, X1, no load current I0, IW, IW, R0, X0, and supply voltage is V1, and current drawn by stator winding is I1. So this is the equivalent circuit. Now, as per the resistance and reactance can be transferred either in the stator side or either in the rotor side. So the equivalent circuit can be represented as all the parameters are going to transfer in the stator side. So here we will just shift the exciting component or shunt component. We will draw first. This is the no load current I0, I mu, IW, R0, X0. Current is I1 here. And here the total resistance is there, and total reactance is there, which is transferred to the stator side. Say it is written at R01 is equal to R1 plus R2 dash, and X0 is equal to X1 plus X2 dash. Means R2 dash is referred from rotor circuit to the stator circuit by dividing the factor K, or we can say that by dividing the ratio of stator winding to the rotor winding. And here RL dash, load resistance referred to the primary side, it is RL upon K square, where K is the ratio of number of turns in the stator winding to the number of turns in the rotor winding. Okay, so or opposite this one. So this is the equivalent circuit of three-phase induction motor. So if you look at the equivalent circuit of three-phase induction motor and equivalent circuit of the transformer, both are same. Only the difference is that here the load resistances get added as compared to the equivalent circuit of the transformer, and which is a variable one depend upon the load condition. Now, this equivalent circuit, I'll draw this equivalent circuit again, the resistance of the stator winding, resistance of reactance of the stator winding, exciting component, and here is the magnetizing component. Resistance of rotor circuit, reactance of rotor circuit, and there is a variable resistance. That is a load resistance is there. So RL is equal to R2 into bracket 1 upon S minus 1, X2 resistance R2, no load current I0, I mu, IW, core loss component R0, X0, reactance of stator winding is X1, and this is R1, current drawn by supply is V1, and this is the supply voltage is V. So this part say this is the input to the stator winding, stator input. Input, which is nothing but root 3 VL IL cos theta, and this is the stator CU loss, which is represented as I1 square R1. This much part is represent the stator core losses. This is a core loss component, stator core loss, and this current is I2 dash. It is referred to the primary side. So this much part is the rotor copper losses, rotor CU loss, which is equal to I2 dash R2. Then mechanical losses, that is windage and frictional loss, and it is the motor output. Motor output. Okay, so it is quite clear to write the balance equation. So before proceeding to the balance equation, R2 is the first part of R2 is as it is, which represent the rotor copper loss, whereas the second part represent the load resistance equivalent to the mechanical output. So this is represent the mechanical output or equivalent to the mechanical output of motor. Okay, now the balance equation, power balance equation. Power balance equation. Power input is equal to 3, because 3 phase, per phase voltage, current per phase into cos theta 1 per phase power. Stator copper core loss. Stator core loss. Core loss is equal to IW, working component of shunt component here, it is R0. Stator CU loss is equal to 3 I1 square R1 is the stator copper. Now power transform to rotor circuit by a air gap is equal to 3 I1 square R1 divided 3 I1, sorry, this is 3 I2 dash square R2 divided by slip. So rotor copper loss, this is 3 I2 square R2 represent the rotor copper loss divided by slip. So rotor CU loss is equal to 3 I2 dash square R2. This is 3 is the 3 phase power, 3 I2 dash square R2. Vector diagram and equivalent circuit is always per phase value. Therefore, mechanical power develop is equal to rotor input via air gap minus rotor CU loss. In rotor circuit, we consider only the rotor copper losses, because the frequency of rotor EMF is very small, 1.5 hertz or 2 hertz. So iron losses are negligible, zero. So only the rotor circuit having copper losses. So rotor input via air gap, 3 I2 dash square R2 divided by slip minus rotor copper loss I2 dash square R2. So from this one, we get mechanical power PM is equal to 3 I2 dash R2 into 1 minus S upon S. Okay. So here the rotor resistance is referred, we can refer it to the primary side also. Okay. So therefore, Tg is the torque. let Tg is the torque developed by rotor. So we can write as Tg is equal to, this is the power divided by angular velocity, So, or we can write as Tg multiplied by omega, is the angular velocity is equal to power, is a Pm. So Tg is equal to 1 upon twice pi n, 60. Okay, so 60 come here, 60 multiplied by 3 I2 dash R2 into bracket 1 minus S upon S. So this is the power balance equation of three-phase induction motor. So by this way, it is concluded that the three-phase induction motor is a generalized three-phase transformer. And this equivalent circuit is used to determine the performance as well as losses in the design application. When you are going to design the motor, first of all, draw the equivalent circuit, change the parameters, and calculate the torque developed by motor, losses are there. So it will help to design what would be the minimum and maximum value of the resistance, which is the best compromise cost criteria, as well as the technical, means technical and commercial, technical and economical best compromise for designing the machine. And torque developed by the motors, as well as from this equivalent circuit, it is quite possible to draw the circle diagram of three-phase induction motor, which is also helpful for calculating the losses, efficiency, torque of induction motor. So this is a that will be the say it is an indirect method of testing. The higher capacity motor cannot be tested on load, so it is tested under no load condition and block rotor test. And from this block rotor test data and no load test data, it is possible to draw the equivalent circuit as well as a circle diagram to determine the losses and efficiency of a three-phase induction motor. So this is the something related to the equivalent circuit of induction motor.